So what is the difference between a good Power BI professional and a great Power BI professional? If you just give me a few minutes, I'm gonna walk you through three examples that will show you how to be a great Power BI professional. And by the way, it is not technical skills or DAX wizardry. And if you watch this video till the end, I'll give you an incredible bonus that will show you how you can update your LinkedIn profile in just 10 minutes to start attracting more Power BI clients and employers to your LinkedIn profile. Just comment the word attract below and I'll send that to you. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online programs on learnpowerbi.com, I've not only been training people in Power BI, but I've also been coaching others since 2019 on how to become successful independent Power BI consultants. So let's see what's the difference between a good versus a great Power BI professional. In general, good Power BI professionals give the customer everything that they want, everything that they ask for. But this is how a great Power BI professional operates differently. So the first example that I want to walk you through, and that often happens with me when I'm working with my clients, is that they ask for a report export, right? So they just ask me that, hey, great. So I show them a Power BI report and they're like, whoa, this is awesome. How can I export this? And again, a good Power BI professional would just say, yeah, you click here, click there, and export data. And maybe the customer would ask for more, that, hey, I want a more detailed table. I want to be able to export more fields. And a good Power BI professional will, you know, just try to do everything they're asking for. So, yep, I'll create a table for you. Oh, you can subscribe to this in email and it'll get it to you. It'll try to give them all they're asking for. But a great Power BI professional, you got to go deeper. And I try to ask them that, great, yep, you know, we can do the export and I can show that to you, but help me understand, what are you gonna do with the export? Right? And again, sometimes it takes a few tries. Sometimes you gotta, you know, kind of talk to the right people. If there's a group, you gotta take somebody aside and just ask them privately, depending on what the sensitivity is. And again, that's one thing that differentiates the great Power BI professional. You gotta kind of read the room. You gotta read the people. So the report export, often once I'm able to exactly understand that what are they doing with the report. So maybe we built a sales dashboard for them and they talk about export. And then I find out that, oh, they're exporting the data and then they're going through and they're finding specific customers with anomalies, which had sharp drops in orders from previous year or something like that. Once I have that understanding, deeper understanding, I can go beyond that and I can say, yep, we had the sales dashboard for you, but if you're looking for specific actionable reports on exactly the top five customers to call today, help me understand the logic that you use and go through to identify that when you're manually reviewing the export, and I will try to build that in Power BI for you. And again, that is going to be an iterative, agile process. So you see the first example, let's walk through the second one. The second example is when I'm starting on a consulting engagement and I'm trying to understand their needs and we're discussing building a report, and they keep asking me for, give me this table, give me that table. And often what I see is that this comes from an audience which has been very Excel focused. And Excel, yes, they can be charting, but a lot of people working in Excel, they're just used to tables and tables and more tables. And of course, in Excel, sometimes there are pivot tables, but hey, they look like tables, right? So they're used to that, so they keep asking Power BI for this. Now, oddly, this can be really challenging in Power BI, and that's one of the mistakes that Power BI professionals make when starting out working with clients, that they select the wrong project. And this is one example of that. If you need a guideline to select the right project, I have a simple shining beacon framework. Just comment the word shining below and I'll give that to you as an extra bonus. So if they keep asking me for tables, now this one is again a bit delicate because they are coming from an Excel background and they do feel more comfortable around tables. So I can't simply ignore what they're saying and say, hey, you know what, Power BI works differently and this is actually better for you. I'm telling you this is better for you. That's not gonna work, right? I mean, that's not how you work with people. So generally my typical approach is I give them the tables. I give them what they're asking for and then I give them some more. So I'll come back maybe after a week. So we do weekly iterations in an agile approach, knock out a project in 30 days typically. So I come back to them and say, hey, here's the tables you asked for. Let me know how it looks. And they say, yep, Avi, that looks great. And then I say, oh, by the way, here are some, you know, kind of nice charts, and Power BI's strength is that it can be very visual. So yeah, if you have a few minutes, kind of walk you through that. And then I walk them through, I show them what that is. And of course I show them the interactivity, which is incredible that you can click this, click that, you can see this trend, see that trend. Now two things happen. Either it blows them away. They're like, whoa, this is cool. Or they're a little guarded, and that's okay. And you know, you gotta match the pace of your client. You gotta walk with them. There's no point, you can't walk in with like the brilliant, whatever, Power BI expert who knows everything. No, you gotta walk with them. That is a sign of a great Power BI professional. So either they're like, yeah, this is awesome, or they're a little guarded, and they're like, and I'm good. So I say, you know what? Why don't you give it a week? We're gonna meet again next week. Give it some time, play around with it. And more often than not, if I go with that approach, rather than trying to shove it down the throat, they come back super excited. And I say, what more can it do? Show us more. And now we're having a very different discussion, and a lot more things have opened up for them for what they can achieve and do with Power BI. So here's the punchline, my friends. A good Power BI professionals give the customers everything that they want, everything they ask for, and they're capable of that. They have the technical skills to do that. But a great Power BI professional does not do that. Instead, they elevate their game to another level where they understand the people and their requirements, and they focus on giving them what they need. And that takes a higher level of skills. But again, as I said at the beginning, being a great Power BI professional is not about the technical skills and DAX wizardry. It's about mastering everything that I walked you through in the examples we covered. And as promised, if you comment the word attract below, I'll send you the bonus, which will show you how you can update your LinkedIn profile in just 10 minutes to start attracting more clients and employers to your profile so that you can serve them better by being a great Power BI professional. Power on, my friends.